Now, I suppose that we can call this the month of flowership. In most town and country districts, the various horticultural societies are organising their annual flower show. As a matter of fact, in my own town, there's one the week after next. Yours may be in a large marquee. It may be only in the village in the parish room. You may only like to go along and look round the show. I hope you do, because they're worthy of support. Or you may like to go along and do a bit of exhibiting. Well, now, I often wonder, you know, when I see so many people looking round the exhibit, if they realise the amount of work that's gone into preparing that show and staging those exhibits. And then I wonder sometimes if they realise what the judges are looking for. Now, I've got one or two examples that I've brought along for you to see, and the first is the vegetable marrow. Now, it isn't always that the prize goes to the largest marrow. You know, the judge is looking for quality, one such as you would like to have on your dining room table. Now, there is one, and if you look carefully at it, on the show bench, you would no doubt see there a tiny thumb mark, the mark of a thumbnail. Well, that's where the judge just presses like that, and if his thumbnail goes in like mine did there, just to make that tiny mark, that tells you that the marrow is young and it's in a perfect condition. So you see, it isn't always size in everything. Now, the next, and one that a lot of people I know like to exhibit in these shows and take a pride in exhibiting, are the onions. For instance, there is an onion weighing over a pound. And I know straight away that you'll say, well, I could never grow an onion like that in my garden. Well, let me tell you now that that onion, and a lot more beside, was grown in a small back garden by a man who makes a hobby of growing vegetables and exhibiting vegetables, and this was his work. He's loaned it me to come along to show you, and the art in staging onions, it's a matter of looking at the schedule, you know. Do exactly what the schedule asks for and no more. And if the schedule says to be shown as grown, then it should be shown with the roots and with the tops complete. Now, you know, a lot of people go wrong by skinning an onion too much. You see there, you've got a skin that's just beginning to break, and here you've got a sort of a blush on the onion. That's where the sun has caught it. That's a good sign. We like to see that. Here is a piece of the older skin. They should never be skinned down and made to look too white. Now, that's a large onion. Now, that's what I would term as a quality onion. Now, there you've got it. Perfect, nice, clean onion. Well ripe. The top there has been removed. The base, the roots there, have been trimmed up. Now, there's no doubt about it that the judge would go for them. But, you know, there's nothing to be ashamed of in not winning prizes. You don't go into these shows, I'm sure, to win prizes every time. You go into a lot of it for the fun of exhibiting. And now, another vegetable that this particular man is very keen on growing is the leek. And there you have one of his leeks grown in the backyard, and I'll tell you now that that was grown in a drain pipe. And the thing that the judge will look for is the length of stem there that is white and blanched, because that is the edible portion of the leek. Now, that should be shown again there with the roots, the clean stem there, and the green tops there. And that's what I would call a good exhibition leek. And while we're talking of onions and leeks, there's another member of that family that we see a lot of in shows, and a lot of people take a pride in showing, and that is the shallots. Now, if the schedule says 12 large shallots, well, they want to be 12 large ones. Or if it says 12 small, they want to be 12 small ones. But if it just says 12 shallots, then choose those of medium size. Don't skin them down. The way to dress a shallot is just to rub off the very loose pieces of skin there, cut off the top, which this time of the year should be dry, and then tie it back neatly there with a piece of raffia, and then get an ordinary plate, put some red sand on the plate, and there you can place your shallots like that so that they look their best. And when the judge comes along, we'll catch his eye, and there you are. They want to be as even as possible. They don't, whatever you do, do too much skinning, because you what they want to look nice. In this case, they're brown, and want to look nice and golden brown and ripe. They may be red, of course, they may be white shallots. But they want to look ripe, and they want to be of an even size. That's one thing that the judge will look for. Now, the next one is peas. Now, you know, the preparation of vegetables for a show takes a lot of time, and it wants doing very carefully. Now, when you're gathering peas, you should always gather and hold the pea by the stalk like that. Never cut hold of the pod like that. You see, on the pod of the pea, there is a natural bloom. Now there, we can see where that pod has been rubbed, and I think if I rub it there, by rubbing off that natural bloom there, that waxy-like covering, you can see it shining. Well, now, you know, a lot of beginners will shine their pod, and I think they're doing the right thing. I think that the judge will give them the prize. Well, of course, that's taking away that natural covering and spoiling your exhibit because you're going to lose points. And then a little piece of parsley just adds to the attractiveness of the exhibit. Now, potatoes. Now, the art in staging an exhibit of potatoes is to have 5 or 6 potatoes, whatever the schedule asks for, of even size. Now there is a very nice variety, one you will often see on the show table. It has a purple eye, and then you've got this beautiful sort of yellowy white, and that is Catriona. And now those want to be as even as possible. For instance, those are kidney potatoes. Now look at the difference in those two. Those are not even, and those two the judge will put together straight away and say, well, no, that's what we want, potatoes even like that. And now, runner beans, of course, you know, there's a lot in growing good runner beans. And runner beans in the shows, up to the moment that I've seen, have been anything from 12 to 16 inches long, and there are some that are as much as 15 inches long. Now those have been carefully grown, and I want you to note again there that those have been cut with a stalk. They've been handled very carefully, and they've been wrapped in a moist cloth to keep them nice and fresh. Because the judge will go along, and he'll want to know straight away whether they're beans that you can eat. He'll catch hold of one, and it should snap like that without any stringing, and that tells him straight away that that's a young bean. Now an art tool in growing, you know, a good runner bean is looking over the rows, just as the beans are beginning to form, and feeling along a pod, a young pod, such as that, when it's about 6 or 8 inches long. And if you feel along, you can just feel the beans forming by lightly pressing, 1, 2, like that, you can just feel those beans crack. Now that will stop the development of the bean in the pod, and all the energy of the plant will go into the production of a pod, and that is the sort of bean that you're aiming. Now, beetroot, I mentioned a moment ago about the care in preparation of vegetables for the show table. Well, you should never put a hard scrubbing brush onto any vegetable because it will show the marks, and there again you're losing points. And beetroot, of course, are judged on colour. Well, now there's 3 beetroot. The size, the suitable size, is about the size of a cricket ball. Now, if those are bruised before they go onto the show table, you'll lose a lot of the colour because the judge will go along, he will take his knife and slice into one like that. Out comes a piece, and there he wants to see a perfect crimson. There, even there, look, we've got that white marking. Well, that is points lost. There is one totally different. The one is a good colour, one is not. There you've got the white one. There you've got one without any white markings at all, and a beautiful deep crimson. Well, that's what the prize is awarded on. The colour and, of course, the shape and the quality comes into it as well. Now, tomatoes, whether they be outside tomatoes grown out of doors, or those grown in the greenhouse, again, they want to be nice and even and of good colour. There we've got 3 6 fruits, all of even size, well coloured, and straight away the judge will turn them over like that, and he will look for this fresh stalk here, colour right to the stalk, the same as it is on the top.
And there again in the presentation, that little piece of parsley. As a matter of fact, those are on a bed of parsley there, and it does set them up and make the colour so much better. But freshness and colour and evenness in size, it isn't always the biggest fruit. They want to be even. Five medium and one large never makes a good dish. Better be six medium fruits. And cucumbers too, whether they be grown in a frame or grown in the greenhouse. Now the thing to look for in a cucumber is this. There again, we've got that natural bloom on the cucumber. And here, it's been cut with a portion of the stalk on, portion of the plant on. And here at the end, the tiny flower. Now that tells us that that cucumber is young and fresh. There's the remains of the flower bud. Always handle them very carefully and lay them preferably on the cucumber leaves. Now, let's leave the vegetables for a moment and look at some fruit. Now, apples, of course, are not very large yet. And there we have five cooking apples. Now, the thing again there is not to polish off that natural bloom. Far too many people will polish apples, and it's totally wrong. They should be staged on the exhibition bench as they're grown, with that covering there, that waxy covering, complete and undisturbed. They should be even, no marks at all, even on the underside of the apple, no rust marks, canker marks, or anything like that. And there again, I like to see, in this case, the apple foliage stage, or the apple stage on the apple foliage. Not put the foliage of another tree underneath the apple. Now, it isn't everyone I know that has got peaches in the garden, but it's surprising the number of people who have got a peach on the wall. And there are five fruits grown outside on a wall. And now those want handling very, very carefully. If you touch a peach like that, put your fingers on the top of a peach like that, within a matter of an hour or so, you'll see those finger marks. The hand should go right over the peach like that. And it should be laid like that on the hand. And to tell if a peach is ripe, turn it over in the hand like that. And that's where you can feel if it's soft there, then your peach is perfectly ripe. You want handling very, very carefully, and taking along to the show carefully too. Now, raspberries have been exceptionally good this time. To pick or to gather raspberries for the exhibition, don't pick them the same as you would to take into the hay for jam making or for dessert. Gather them with the stalks like that. Leave this part in the fruit. You can then move them about like that without damaging the berry at all. And there again, you see, we've got the raspberry foliage on the plate underneath the raspberry. And if the schedule says 12, 18, whichever you ask for, make sure you've got that number and no more. Morella cherries are about at their best now, and during the next week or two, I expect we shall see quite a lot at the shows. And there again, a stalk, nice and fresh, and a really nice dark crimson berry, crimson fruit, well coloured, and there again on its own, on the cherry foliage. Handle them as little as you can. When you do handle them always by the stalk, and then there's no fear of damaging the fruits at all. Now, there are very few people who've got vineries these days, but when you go along to a show and you see some lovely black grapes or even white grapes, you'll sometimes wonder, I know, what the judges look for and how has he decided on his first, second and third. Well, now there's a bunch of black grapes, and there again, on each one of those berries, we've got a natural bloom. Now, if I just rub my finger on a berry there, that natural bloom is gone, and nothing we can do to replace it. So when the bunch is gathered, it should be held by the stalk, hold it up, and choose the best side, so that you will have the best side towards the judge or towards the public. Lay it on something soft, and whenever you pick it up and lay it down again, always lay it on the same side. Because once you've disturbed that bloom, you'll never get it back, and it's points lost and possibly a prize lost. And you know, there's a great honour in winning a prize for a nice bunch of grapes like that. I expect you're interested in roses. You like roses. Most people do. Now, I often wonder how many people realize that the rose, of course, is not growing on its own roots. It's growing on a briar stock. It's growing on a common briar root. Well, now, most gardeners and nurserymen are at this time of the year busy budding roses. You possibly don't want to bother to do that in your garden, but, you know, it's always interesting to know how these jobs are done. First of all, then, we've got a briar rootstock. There is our briar rootstock. There is the seedling briar that was planted. Just scratch the soil away. And on there, we can bud or slip in a bud of a rose of our particular favourite, possibly a philia or peace or something like that, and it will grow. Now, having got the briar established, we take a well-ripened and a well-developed shoot from our rose, whichever variety we want. And this is where the budding knife comes in. We place the knife above the bud like that, cut down into it, slide it along, and so cut off a shield of bark with a bud and leaf on like that. Trim off half the leaf, and then just remove that piece of wood from the back of the bud. There, we have left now. Sorry, we have to do another one. By cutting it out like this, and just removing that piece of wood from the back. Now there we have just the bark, the bud, and the leaf. And we trim off part of that leaf so. Now, with the knife, cut across our bar stem like that. Up so that we form a T. Now with the point of the knife, just turn back the bark so on each corner, and then with this is where the bone of the knife comes in. We slide that down to loosen the bark on either side. Then we take our bud and we slip that down underneath that piece of bark so. Holding it in position like that, and then trimming off that top piece there. Now the cambium of our bud there and our stock is in contact. Then with a piece of raffia, we bind it tightly to hold it in. And over the top, and we can just tie it or just loop it in. And there, that bud will grow. And in March of next year, we can cut the briar off there, and this bud will grow and give us our rose. Now, here, for instance, is a rose that was done exactly 12 months ago. There you see you have your briar stock, your briar root stock. And here, growing from it, that one bud has produced 2, 4, 5 growths, and those have already flowered this year. Now, possibly, you would like to do that. You would like to get a briar root this next winter. Move the base of the roots there have been trimmed up. Now, there's no doubt about it that the judge would go for them. But, you know, there's nothing to be ashamed of in not winning prizes. You don't go into these shows, I'm sure, to win prizes every time. You go into a lot of it for the fun of exhibiting. And now another vegetable that this particular man is very keen on growing is the leek. And there you have one of his leeks grown in the backyard, and I'll tell you now that that was grown in a drain pipe. And the thing that the judge will look for is the length of stem there that is white and black, perfect condition. So you see, it isn't always size in everything. Now, the next, and one that a lot of people I know like to exhibit in these shows and take a pride in exhibiting, are the onions. For instance, there is an onion weighing over a pound. And I know straight away that you'll say, well, I could never grow an onion like that in my garden. Well, let me tell you now that that onion, and a lot more beside, was grown in a small back garden by a man who makes a hobby of growing vegetables and exhibiting vegetables, and this was his work. He's loaned it me to come along to show you, and the art in staging onions, if the matter of fact, it's a matter of looking at the schedule, you know. Do exactly what the schedule asks for and no more. And if the schedule says to be shown as grown, then it should be shown with the roots and with the top complete. Now, you know, a lot of people go wrong by skinning an onion too much. You see there, you've got a skin that's just beginning to break, and here you've got a sort of a blush on the onion. That's where the sun has caught it. That's a good sign. We like to see that. Here is a piece of the older skin. They should never be skinned down and made to look too white. Now, that's a large onion. Now, that's what I would term as a quality onion. Now, there you've got it. Perfect, nice, clean onion. Well, right. The top there has been removed. Now, I suppose that we can call this 3 months of flowering. In most town and country districts, the various horticultural societies are organising their annual flower show. As a matter of fact, in my own town, there's one the week after next. Yours may be in a large marquee. It may be only in the village and in the parish room. You may only like to go along and look round the show. I hope you do, because they're worthy of support. Or you may like to go along and do a bit of exhibiting. Well, now, I often wonder, you know, when I see so many people looking round the exhibit, if they realise the amount of work that's gone into preparing that show and staging those exhibits. And then I wonder sometimes if they realise what the judges are looking for. Now, I've got one or two examples that I've brought along for you to see. And the first is the vegetable marrow. Now, it isn't always that the prize goes to the largest marrow. You know, the judge is looking for quality, one such as you would like to have on your dining room table. Now, there is one, and if you look carefully at it, on the show bench, you would no doubt see there a tiny thumb mark, the mark of a thumbnail. Well, that's where the judge just presses like that, and if his thumbnail goes in like mine did there, just to make that tiny mark, that tells you that the marrow is young, and it's in